Please. So welcome everyone to this very special moment in Maria and Greg's life. They've chosen a biblical passage, the Corinthians 13, verses 4 through 8, to begin this afternoon ceremony because it expresses their feelings of love and grace on this wonderful day. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but it rejoices with the truth. Love believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. If all of these were to end, three remain. Faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Welcome, family and friends. We're gathered here today before God to celebrate the marriage of Maria and Greg. We are gathered to rejoice in the gift of love that the Creator has shared with us. We affirm today that God is both the Creator and the Sustainer of life and desires us to fully experience our humanity. None of us can be an isolated island without the need of community. We offer praise and thanks to God, who has blessed us with the wonder of life, breath, hearts, minds, and souls. We rejoice in the realization that we are most alive when we wholeheartedly embrace the gifts that God has given us, especially God's gift of love, in all the ways that the gift is bestowed upon us. Maria and Greg, to create a life together with the blessing of God requires that you honor the divine in each other and in yourselves, that you honor the many voices of the soul, the joys, the delights, the love, as well as the anger, the fear, the illness, the unhealed wounds, that you not ask your life partner to be any less than a fully formed person, committed to you in love, but still possessed by that strange and sometimes bewildering gift of freedom. We're here to accept our life partners for all that they are, embracing each other in all our complexities, in times of delight, in the fullness of dreams, in the moments of sorrows, conflict, loss. This is both God's blessing and charge to you to live together with courage and honor, whatever time in its unfolding mystery may bring. Marie and Greg, I will ask you now perhaps the most important question that you have been asked to this moment, in this world, in this life. And these are promises that you are making to each other. And I will ask you, Maria, first, and look at your beloved, Maria Rosegarth, do you take Gregory Daryl Benny to be your lawfully wedded husband? Do you vow to love him and care for him as long as you both shall live? Do you accept him with all his faults and strengths, mm-hmm, and offer yourself to him with all of your own faults and strengths? Do you promise to be faithful and a loving companion, and to always put the promises you make on this day above all else? And will you, Maria, promise your life to him in all love and honor, in all duty, in all service, in all faith and tenderness, to live with him and cherish him according to the ordinance of God in the holy bond of marriage?
I do.
And Gregory Daryl Benny, do you take Maria Rosegarth to be your lawfully wedded wife? Do you vow to love her and care for her for as long as you both shall live? Do you accept her with all of her faults and strengths, and offer yourself to her with all of your own faults and strengths? Do you promise to be faithful and loving companion, and to always put the promises you make above all else? And will you promise your life to her in all love and honor, in all duty and service, in all faith and tenderness, to live with her, cherish her, according to the ordinance of God in the holy bond of marriage?
I do.
Ladies and gentlemen, today is the public affirmation and acknowledgement of all that these two people are to each other. And seemingly, your relationship will be as it has always been. Yet, there is the power of the spoken word. May that power bring you warmth and closeness, security and comfort, joy and happiness in everything that this world has to offer you. And because words matter, and because they care so much for each other, Greg and Maria are going to share those vows with each other privately. And they will share with you that they love each other, they are committed to each other, they're not going anywhere. They will be forever and ever together. Traditionally, the passage of single man and woman to husband and wife is marked by the exchange of rings. May I have the rings, please? These rings are a symbol of the unspoken, unbroken circle of love. Love freely given has no beginning, it has no end. It has no giver, it has no receiver, for each is the giver and each is the receiver. May these rings always remind you of the vows that you have taken here today. Maria, will you place this ring on your beloved's left ring finger and repeat after me? Greg, with this ring.
Greg, with this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Wear it as a symbol.
Wear it as a symbol.
Of our love.
Of our love.
Commitment.
Commitment.
And promises.
And promises.
We have made to each other here today.
We have made to each other here today.
And Greg, take this ring and place it in Maria's ring finger. And please repeat after me. Maria, with this ring.
Maria, with this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Wear it as a symbol.
Wear it as a symbol.
Of our love.
Of our love.
Commitment.
Commitment.
And promises.
And promises.
We have made to each other today.
We have made to each other today.
Maria's beautiful daughter now has a song she would like to share with us.
Congratulations, Greg and Mom, and we couldn't be more happy to have you added to the family.
Thank you.
I chose the excerpt from a song by Adele because it talks about how that private space that a couple shares is intimate and it's sacred, and it's that space where people should be able to be the most authentic version of themselves.
Whenever I'm alone with you, you make me feel like I am home again. Whenever I'm alone with you, you make me feel like I am free again. However far away, I will always love you. However far away, I will always love you.
Thank you, son.
We don't want no sweaty on the kiss.
No, no. All right, son.
He knows what's coming.
All right, guys.
We will offer a prayer in closing. And it is this. Almighty and ever-blessed God, whose presence is the happiness of every condition, and whose favor hallows every relation. We beseech you to be present and favorable upon these, your servants, that they may be truly joined in the honorable estate of marriage, in the covenant of their God. As you have brought them together by your providence, sanctify them by your Spirit, giving them a new frame of heart fit for their new estate. Enrich them with all grace, whereby they may enjoy the comforts, undergo the cares, endure the trials, and perform the duties of life together under your guidance and protection.
through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Marie and Greg have pledged yourselves to each other by speaking vows, joining hands, giving and receiving rings. It is therefore now my honor and my privilege, by the authority vested in me, under the laws of this great state of Florida, to now pronounce you husband and wife. Greg, you may kiss your bride.
There it goes, there it goes.
Jerome, Jerome!